Good afternoon, guys. I'm again here to discuss a weekly, to discuss our weekly analysis, and it's Monday. I hope you guys had a good session last week, and to continue with that, first we'll start discussing about dollar index chart, as what we do every time. So if you see the dollar index chart, first of all, let's see the candlestick closing. It's a bullish candlestick closing, and it has this moving average. If you notice, this is a 30 weighted moving average, which I personally use for my strategy. This is acting as a very strong support recently, if you notice this entire line, and market has again taken a support and has closed like a bullish candlestick. Another thing, if what you notice is every time it's making a higher low, which is again an indication for upward side. But one thing what you need to be careful about is it hasn't closed above the resistance, the level which I'm expecting it to break out. It has again closed near that, it hasn't closed above that. So that is one thing we need to be careful about. But everything else is indicating that it should break out at any time soon. So there are high chances that market should be bullish, especially dollar index should be bullish. So I can clearly see a strong resistance here, which I'm saying it is not able to break out, which is this. If you see this blue trend line, it was initially a resistance, became a support, again became a resistance. And market, though it has closed strong, but if it would have closed above this level like a strong bullish candle, it would have been a clear indication of breakout, which it did not do. So just be careful. Though it is at the resistance, so it is expected to do a good pullback, which is again for Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday, and again by Thursday and Friday, or maybe mid Wednesday also, you can expect a good bullish movement, and next week could be a very good breakout candle. That is what it's indicating. Another thing what you can see here is like an ascending triangle formation also. If I remove this trend line, as I said, we can see higher swing lows forming, and you can see this highs are same. If I draw a horizontal trend line, if this red line itself is indicating that, but if I draw a horizontal line, you can see this high, this high, this high. Here also it was a resistance, here also this zone if you consider. So it is also like an ascending triangle. So the breakout, which again indicates that there are higher chances that breakout should happen on the upside. So overall I am bullish for dollar index for this week. But again, I would not buy at least today or tomorrow, or maybe I'll wait for a 4-hourly setup to buy. Because as it's a resistance, again we have to remember, so there are chances that market can come down from here. So just keep checking your daily closings and accordingly you can take a call. Overall, I expect dollar to break out this week is what I would say. Close like a strong bullish candle. The movement I'm expecting on Thursday and Friday, major movement, till or maybe Wednesday also, but first 2 days I'm expecting it to retrace, do a major retracement or at least 50% of this, and then market can shoot up on Thursday and Friday. So it would so this week candle closing would be very important. Either this will become a strong resistance if it closes like a bearish candle, which becomes an engulfing, then next week we'll be on the selling side. But if this level breaks out, which there are higher chances, if this level breaks out, then this becomes a support and we'll buy at the pullback. So this is my view on dollar index. So keep checking your daily candles. Maybe for today, tomorrow, you might get sell confirmations. But be careful from Wednesday, Thursday and Friday. It could happen that you can be on the buying side. Like there are high chances that you get buying confirmations. So that's about dollar index. So as we have discussed about dollar, another thing we need to discuss is about gold. As we discussed last week also, gold and dollar has an inverse correlation. So we'll check gold chart. XAUUSD. If you see gold chart closing, just a second. though closing is like a small rejection, if you see, though if you remember last week there was a bearish candlestick confirmation and market fell down strongly and we made good money on gold as well. But this week, if you see, there's a small support here. If you see, if you can see this, this market got a support here. Also here, one candle, two candle, three candle, again the fourth candle, it's like a rejection also. So what gold is also trying to indicate that it can do a pullback this week. And so with this, again, you can be a bit careful, as dollar, you can see it is at a good resistance just now. And gold has also taken a support. So there are chances also that this week market can go slightly up. But eventually, it can, maybe on Thursday and Friday, it can just make a spike and eventually fall down. So with gold also, currently, once you get a pullback, it could be bullish for 1, 2, 3 days. But Thursday and Friday is two important days, and how the candle closes, then it can break this level also. If dollar shoots up, gold will fall down. So both are interconnected in an inverse proportion. So just be careful. I would say that keep checking daily candles, though weekly is at a area wherein, if you see, gold is at a support, small support, or in fact if you see, it's been a very good support line, the trend line which I have drawn. So gold is at a support, dollar is at the resistance. If the breakout happens, gold will continue to fall down, dollar will shoot up. But if the breakout is not happening, because you cannot, I mean, we are just expecting a breakout to happen. We are counting our odds in our favor. But there are always chances that breakout might not happen, and then gold will become a buy and dollar will become a sell. So this week, candle closing will give a lot more clarity. So as we have discussed about dollar, we can check dollar pairs, which are major pairs. Talking about Euro USD. So as if you see this also, Euro USD closed like a big bearish candle, but again it could not break a very strong support which was initially a resistance. This green line itself indicates, the current price line itself indicates that. So I don't need to draw a trend line. So if you notice that, again, same, just exact opposite scenario of this dollar index setup. A dollar has closed like a strong bullish candle but could not break the resistance. Same goes here. But if you notice the entire setup, I'm more on the selling side of Euro USD, first of all, because of the momentum just now the candle has, because it is a big bearish candle, body dominating. So that is one reason. Another reason is swing highs are getting lower. If you see, constantly swing highs are getting lower, and it's also a descending triangle formation, wherein there are high chances market can just break out on the downside. So I'll be bearish on Euro USD. Another thing, if you remember, we also discussed about this head and shoulder pattern. So that has also indicated us that it should be on the sell side, as head and shoulder is a very strong setup. So that is also head and shoulder breakout, pullback, and it still needs to continue the downward trend. Another thing, so there are multiple reasons for it to go down. Just one reason for it can go up is that it is at a support. That's the only reason I could see. Otherwise, all other reasons I could clearly see that it should be a very strong sell. So I would be looking to sell maybe around Wednesday, Thursday, when I get a proper pullback, I get a confirmation, and my risk is also small. I would be mainly betting on the sell side. Though it is at a decent support, but candlestick confirmation is what indicating, and this is also a resistance, and the momentum of the candle is also telling the same. Another thing what I could see is, initially if you can see, there is a diagonal channel also, the breakout of which has happened after long. See, this was a channel formation. channel formation and market did a breakout, it did a pullback, and again there was just a strong bearish candle at the pullback. So that's why I am strongly on the sell side, though I'm expecting some pullback to happen, at least 50% of that, which should happen on Monday and Tuesday. And Wednesday, Thursday and Friday, I'm expecting it to fall and finally break this support. So that's my analysis on Euro-USD. Same goes with JPY-USD also. If you see the candlestick wise, C dollar was very strong last week. You can see a clear engulfing, and that too at the resistance. I think that's a very clean trend line that everyone should notice, that there's a very... So this is the... Yeah, see, this is the trend line, which was initially a slight support. It was taking a support, did a breakout. Then with the pin bar, it rejected again. Now it rejected with a proper engulfing. So GBP looks strongly weak to me. If you check other GBP pairs also, which I've already checked. So GBP looks strongly weak to me, and dollar looks strong comparatively. And GBP USD would be one of the trade I would be keeping a check on. And GBP USD looks like a strong sell. NCD USD, if you see, NCD USD does not have very strong bearish closing, which clearly indicates that NCD also is a little on the stronger side. Because everywhere else, if you see the dollar pairs, you will see a bullish closing. But here, you can just see a very slight rejection candle, that too with a small bearish body. So which means that even dollar was strong, and NCD US, NCD also as a pair was on the upside, and that's why the closing is like this. And if you can see, there's a symmetrical triangle. Most of the places we were seeing ascending or descending triangles, but here I can see a symmetrical setup. This trend line can be further extended also, and this is a symmetrical setup, which means breakout can happen on either of the side. Basically, my focus would not be much on NCD USD, because NCD also looks slightly bullish, whereas dollar, I am expecting mainly to eventually be on the buying side. Just now, I'm expecting some retracement, so I would not focus much. For me, GP USD should be a better trade. Now, talking about AUD USD, AUD, yeah, it has a bearish closing. So AUD USD looks like a good sell in comparison to NCD USD. Now this gives a lot of clarity about AUD and NCD also as an individual pair. AUD looks weaker than NCD because it has a good bearish closing. So if you check AUD NCD as a pair, it should indicate for a sell. See, it's clearly indicating for a sell. Why? Because AUD is weak and NCD is strong in comparison to AUD. So this gives us a lot of clarity again. We are on the selling side of AUD. We are on the buying side of NCD. But it depends on which pairs we relate it with. So that I'll explain in some time. So overall, if USD CAD also, if we check, there's a strong bullish closing, which means dollar was bullish. Again, if we check USD CHF. Yeah. USDCHF also has a very strong bullish closing, though it is at a resistance, which is again with all dollar pairs. But the closing wise, it's a very strong bullish momentum candle. So everywhere, if you notice, there's a bullish closing of dollars because of last week, but only in NCDUSD and USDJPY. USDJPY shows us a bearish closing here, which clearly indicates that JPY was also very strong. So one of the important thing is I would be focusing a lot on JPY this week, because everything else, if you check in dollar pairs, has a bullish closing. In fact, NCD USD also has a spinning top, which is an indecision type of a setup, but only USD JPY has a strong sell setup, if you see, which means JPY is way more stronger than dollar. So this gives me a very good clarity about JPY also. I should be on the buying side of JPY, which clearly means JPY should be a strong sell. See, it's a very strong sell. Euro JPY should be a sell. See, and Euro JPY, you can also clearly see a very, very strong breakout pullback setup, which is very clean also. See, this was a strong support breakout pullback with an engulfing. Don't sell at the current price. I would suggest that wait for pullback as it's Monday and then you can sell. So JPY looks very strong. AUD JPY sell. Even Euro JPY sell. AUD JPY should be a good sell in comparison to NCD JPY, because NCD was looking a little stronger. See, candlestick confirmation is also not that strong, though it's an engulfing, but it's not as strong like you saw in case of JP JPY or you saw in case of AUD JPY. They have way more stronger setups, and this is also a breakout pullback setup if you notice in AUD JPY. This was a breakout, this did a pullback. So, in fact, if you say CHF JPY also, it has a, such a strong bearish setup because CHF is weak and JPY is strong. So, like I said in last weekend session also, it's very important that if you choose one weak and one strong pairs, and it gives you a lot of clarity while trading. So, CHF JPY is a very strong sell. So, all the JPY pairs, if you notice, even CAD JPY, you can notice is a strong sell. You can clearly see a strong breakout pullback, especially with the evening star here. Though it has reached a small support is what I could see. So it can do a major pullback till here and then you should be looking to sell. And also with CAD, let me first check oil to have a clarity. Okay, oil chart is not there. I'll just... Yeah, it's here. Okay, seeing oil chart, the closing is like a spinning top, but is still above, slightly above the moving average. Here, I would want to draw a Fibonacci to have a better clarity. Fibonacci retracement from this high, which was a vertical fall, to this low. So it is up playing above 38.2, and if you see, this was a resistance converted support, and there's a spinning top at the support. So my higher chances for it to go towards is towards the upside. So I would be bullish on oil, though it's not very strongly bullish till the time market breaks this level. But yes, I would be on the buying side of oil, which means I should be on the buying side of CAD, which means GBP CAD, because GBP is weak and CAD is comparatively stronger. GBP CAD should be a sell. Let us check GBP CAD chart. Yeah, it's here. See, it's indicating for sell, and I could also clearly see a channel formation, though I can also see a very strong breakout pullback trend line, or you can call it as a support converted resistance trend line, which is a very strong trend line. Also, you can draw a channel. You can draw a parallel channel. I can draw a parallel line. You can also use a channel tool to draw a parallel line. See, and there is a rejection exactly at the resistance. Another trend line which I can see is this. This was a resistance, again a resistance, again this is a resistance. So GBP CAD. So everywhere if you notice, GBP is looking weak. So try to connect GBP or try to connect AUD is looking weak, a little weak comparatively, though potential of pullback is there. You can connect it with all strong pairs. In fact, Euro is weak, but if you compare Euro and GBP, I think GBP is more weaker. So Euro GBP setup should be indicating for a buy. Let's check that. See, it is at a support. And also, I can see a very strong trend line setup here. This is a very clean trend line, which is a very strong support here. And it's indicating for a buy. See, before seeing the chart itself, I was very clear that Euro GBP should be a buy because GBP is more weaker than Euro. So that's the type of clarity you get when you study about correlation. and I'm expecting it to go up till here, which would be a, this was a fall, which is a downtrend. So this basically would be a retracement, but this retracement is also a lot. So for this week, I should be bullish. When the market comes around this area and we get a setup somewhere around here, then we'll decide whether we'll be selling or not, depending on the candle closing. But if I'm buying here, I should be buying till here. That should be my first target. So I think we have almost covered all the pairs. So I'll just summarize everything. Dollar looks strong, but not against JPY. One thing, JPY is looking the strongest of all just now, the way the candles have closed. So anything against JPY, if you compare, in fact, dollar is also strong, JPY strong is also strong. But if you see USD, JPY, if you compare USD and JPY, JPY is more stronger. Okay, that is one thing. CAD is also looking strong, but if you compare CAD with JPY, it will be weaker, comparatively weaker. If you compare Canadian dollar with dollar, it would be comparatively weaker. So priority wise, these all three are on the bullish side, which is JPY, CAD and dollar. But on priority wise, JPY is the strongest, then comes dollar, and then comes Canadian dollar. So that's my analysis for this week, and then come maybe NCD also. It is also comparatively stronger if you compare it with AUD or GBP. So it depends on which pair you link it with. Like for example, if you trade NCD with JPY, it will definitely be weaker. Let's say NCD, JPY, if we check. See, it's looking not a very strong sell setup like all other JPY setups, but yes, still indicating for a sell. If you compare NCD with USD, it should be indicating for a sell, though it could not be a very strong setup, but still. Or you can also compare NCD CAD. So NCD CAD is looking like a buy. Here it's looking like a bullish setup. So there's a slight change. Then I check NCD. NCD is looking strong. In fact, it is looking stronger than CAD. So priority wise, I'll just modify it a little because I noticed NCD CAD just now. Strongest is JPY. Then comes dollar. Then comes NCD. Or dollar and NCD could be equally strong because NCD USD as a setup has a indecision candle. It depends on that point of time what is most strong. See, NCD USD has a slight setup which is playing in between this level. So it depends on which side it breaks out. So NCD and dollar could be both on the second priority, and then third priority comes to Canadian dollar in terms of being strong. GBP looks very weak against everything. If you compare it against any currency pair, GBP is looking weak just now, the way it has closed. Now remaining CHF, Euro and AUD, they all three are weak, but not as weak as GBP, but they are weaker than all other currency pairs like NCD, like Canadian dollar. So in order to summarize, in order to summarize the entire situation, try to link one strong and one weak pair. So it would be best if you link the strongest with the weakest, which is GBP with JPY. So this week I would keep a strong eye on GBP JPY as a pair, though I'll not sell at the current price because see, GBP JPY setup, it's such a strong setup and it's also at a resistance trend line, and it's a proper shift of momentum from buying to selling. I'll not buy at the current price. I'll wait for a pullback so that I get a better risk to reward ratio. But I'm strongly on the selling side of JP, JPY. So yeah, that's my analysis for this week. I hope you are trying to understand the correlation. It depends on which currency you correlate with. It's very important to understand that if you are connecting Canadian dollar with JPY, though both are strong, but JPY is more stronger. So these are the minute details which we need to consider. So CAD JPY overall should be a sell. See, CAD JPY setup, it's a proper breakout pullback. So we need to also analyze, it's not only about knowing what is strong and weak, it's also about knowing what is more stronger and what is more weaker. Okay, so I hope this video is helpful, and I hope everyone make a lot of money using this direction. Try to stick to this direction and trade as per your strategy in smaller time frames. The more you are with the trend, safer you are, better probability of success towards your side. Thank you guys. Have a good trading week. See you again next Monday. Goodbye.